Apple Notes has long been one of the most underrated note-taking apps on the market, and it has been growing in popularity since, as well as in features. Today we're going to dive into the best features that you might not know, as well as the brand new iOS 18 features that it will take you to the next level. We're also going to look at a brand new framework that will help you to use Apple Notes as your planner, journal, and your task management system. Today's video, we're getting everything you need to know about Apple Notes in one video. Welcome, my name is Francesco D'Alessio and welcome to Toolfinder. We're gonna help you find the best productivity tools. So if you're not subscribed, hit subscribe. And also if you're interested in the top ranked note-taking applications, you can find a link to that report below. You can also get a buyer's guide to help you find the best noting app, whether it's Apple Notes or whether it's not. So I think the best place to start is with these features that are gonna take your Apple Note use to the next level. The first of those is with the quick note feature. For example, whether you're in a website or whether you're not, you can use the quick note feature to quickly add any item. You can add pieces of text or the whole link, and you can choose whether to add the link or not. And you can add these to existing notes as part of your Apple Notes. Now, for those iPhone 15 Pro users and the iPhone 15 Pro Max, as well as the brand new iPhone 16 users, you can use the new action button, which will help you to quickly save a note. All you have to do that is go to settings, choose what action button you want. In this case, shortcut, and then choose quick note. This is a great way to press a button, hold it down, and quickly take a note when you're thinking of one on the go. Many people are liking that Apple Notes has a linking ability. This creates a bi-directional link between one note and another, allows you to do things like create a table of contents, but also be able to link notes and use them and reuse them across your account. To do this, you can select any piece of text and press add link. Then you get the option to choose the text that overlays this, or you can choose and show the title that it already has, which is updated in real time. Perfect for creating a table of contents that might be constantly changing. Something we'll dive into a little bit later. Now, inside of any of your notes, you can annotate PDFs, which is a real benefit. And if you want to go that step further, on the iPad version, if you swipe with the Apple Pencil in the left-hand corner, you can take a screenshot and then turn that into an annotation itself. This is perfect for if you've got a website, you want to leave some feedback, and you can get the full page from this, which is a great experience. Perfect for sharing with other people externally. Now, filters and sorting are also underrated in Apple Notes. You can use these to really narrow down your options and create these smart folders that pick all of the best notes for the right use case. For example, if you wanted to, you could have it filtered by tags, which could be type of meetings you have, as well as a date created, meaning you could see all your meetings that were agenda-based for AGMs in September. And this is a great way to quickly see all of that at one time. You could also use app mentions to see anyone app mentioned for any travel plans that you've got coming up with friends. The possibilities are endless. But one of the things that people don't know about Apple Notes is you can actually collaborate and share inside of it. I tried this for several months with my wife as a way to plan and organize what we were having for tea and what we were planning for the week ahead. It is a really useful feature. You could share and see everyone in real time and what they're working on inside of the note. You can also see an activity log of what was changed inside the note, as well as swipe to the left and see everything at a glance, which is a great experience. Now, of course, privacy is super important with Apple Notes, which you can now Face ID lock any of your notes, which is perfect for securing your notes. So now to the iOS 18 specific stuff. And the first feature is recording an audio message. Now you're probably wondering, what's the benefit to doing this? Well, you can record an audio message for yourself, or you can record something that you're working on. But most importantly, it will transcribe this item for you, helping to get an idea of what was said in text form, which is a perfect addition to your Apple Notes. And you can also now do this with phone calls, which is a great way to transcribe anything that was mentioned in a phone call so that you don't miss out on it. Now, there's another option in the new iOS 18 to turn any of your text into highlighted colors. This is perfect for defining things, especially with study notes and things like that. Now, you can also access a quick note and new notes through Spotlight search, which is a benefit to quickly finding and typing in a note if you don't have the action button. And any heading is collapsible, which is a great way to pop things open and shut them away when you're not using them. Now, of course, all the math notes abilities are really advanced. You can write down any question like 5 plus 5 and it'll automatically automatically do it in text, but you can also use a calculator function to use your Apple Pencil to work out sums, and everything will be saved into a maths notes folder, which is perfect. Now also, you can access the control center and now add an iOS note function for quickly adding stuff there, which again is another place to find it if you don't have the action button. Now finally, Apple Intelligence isn't quite with us yet, but if you're interested in the Apple Intelligence video, hopefully we can do it. If you're interested in it, you can subscribe, and in the comments below, share something like Apple Intelligence video, please. That's a prompt for me to do it. So before we dive into the crazy framework that I found, there are actually other applications which I didn't know about that you can extend your Apple Notes experience. And one of them is called Pron Notes app. And this is basically a Mac app that you can use for free. There is a $7.99 upgrade for the AI abilities in it, but essentially it allows markdown, slash commands, and templates, which are gonna help you to improve how you're using Apple Notes. And it naturally syncs with those Apple Notes as well, and just brings it to a more markdown focused experience than you may be common with apps like Bear Notes and things like that. So you can find that linked below as well. There's also a site called Quotation, or Quotion, probably a play on the words emotion or notion, but you can turn Apple Notes into websites really quickly. So if you're looking to create something basic, then you turn it into and hook it up with one of their domains. This is great for sharing with others, but maybe a very niche use case. I just thought those tools were pretty interesting. So now onto the crazy framework that I found. And this framework was developed by Matthias Hilse, who is inspired by the concept by Ryder Carroll, bullet journaling, and obviously by Tiago Forte in the power methodology. And he's taken this impassion and this framework to introduce it into Apple Notes. And the idea behind it is called the forever at notes. And essentially what you do here is turn any of your note into a powerhouse for organizing things like your planning for your journal in your calendar, for example, goals and monthly insights, as well as a review where it allows you to break things down every single month. It also helps you to create these hubs where you can plan projects or organize documentation for something that might be important for you. And it also allows collections as well, so that you can bring together things like book notes, recipes, resources, and trips that you got planned, but have it in a really organized fashion. This experience will take time to set up. And if you're interested, I'm gonna do a full video on this, but I actually initially started playing around with this. And it's quite a cool concept, because the idea is to link everything up using backlinks. And once you've done it, it's created from there. So I created a homepage, and I started with the calendar set up in creating a area for 2024 for the years, and also planning Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4. And I found it a really nice experience. And the fact that you can use this in a micro experience with the asterisks being your helpful setup is really, really cool. So if you want to see a video on that, an expanded tour of Forever Notes, it's a free framework. I'll include the website below, but I will do a full video if you're interested. It's a really interesting system. And as somebody who developed the Bentoo methodology, which is a framework about reducing the amount of tasks that you have, it's so good to see somebody else create a system like this and help you implement it as well. So I'm really excited to do the video, but it's another way that you can take your Apple Notes and extend it that step further. And it's all free. There's a full guide to it linked below as well. But if you're interested in setting it up with me, then let me know in the comments below. So that was your ultimate tour to Apple Notes. It's a powerful tool that might help you to better note take, but primarily better manage your productivity on the go, thanks to it being in your pocket and accessible pretty much Apple-centric locations. So thank you very much. If you're new here, do subscribe. And if you fancy checking out that top-ranked note-taking apps, you can find that linked below. But it's been a pleasure having you, and I'll see you in the next video, and hopefully to upgrade your productivity. Cheerio.